Dear learners, welcome to the course Electromagnetic Fields. In this video, I am going to explain how to solve the problems based on Coulomb's law. Here I am going to explain three examples based on Coulomb's law. First example, we consider two 40 gram MOSes each with a charge of 3 microcoulomb are placed 50 cm apart. Compare the gravitational force between the two masses to the electric force between the two masses. Ignore the force of the earth on the two masses. So now we are going to calculate the gravitational force and electric force between the two masses. First, we draw the diagram. First, we have to read the statement of the problem two or three times. Then we should interpret the statement into vectorial representation. Then only we can easily solve the problems. First we draw the diagram. Masses, 40 gram mass, 3 microcoulomb charge. Two masses are separated at distance 50 cm. As we know that the gravitational force is Fg is equal to g m1 m2 by r square. We substitute the gravitational constant 6.67 into 10 power minus 11 and also substitute the M1 M2 masses 40 gram and the distance between the two masses is 50 cm, but we have to write it in SI units. It should be in kilogram and meters. We will get 4.27 into 10 power minus 13 newtons. Then we have to calculate the electric force between the two charges. Fp is equal to k q1 q2 by r square. We substitute the value of k 9 into 10 power 9. Charges are 3 into 10 power minus 6. That is 3 microcoulomb. The distance between the two charges is 50 cm. We substitute it. Finally, we will get 0.324 newtons. Now, we compare the gravitational force, which is 4.27. And we compare electric force is 0.324 newtons. The electric force is much greater than the gravitational force. So in this way, we solve the we calculate the electric force between the two charges and the gravitational between the two masses. The second example, I consider a charge Q 2 is equal to 10 microcoulomb is located in air at point minus 3, 1, 4 meter. Find the force on Q2 due to Q1 3 microcoulomb located at point P 3, minus 8, minus 2, meters. In the problem, two charges are given Q2, Q1 and the location of the charges are also given. Q2 is at point minus 3, 1, 4. The charge Q1 is at the location 3, 8, minus 2. Now we are going to find the force on the charge Q2 due to the charge Q1. So the direction of the force is along the straight line joining the two charges Q1, Q2. The distance between the charges Q1 and Q2 is represented as r vector. First we draw the picture from the statement of the problem. According to Coulomb's law, first we write the force F2 vector is equal to Q1 Q2 by 4 pi epsilon naught r square ar vector. So after mentioning Q1, Q2 and draw the line joining between the Q1 and 2, we write the r vector. R vector is the distance vector. It is nothing but the difference between the two position vectors at point Q1 and Q2. We are going to calculate the force acting on Q2 due to the charge Q1. So we find the difference of position vector at point 2 and the position vector at point P1. So now we are getting that is minus 3 minus of 3 plus 3 and 1 minus 8 AY vector plus 4 minus minus 2 AZ vector. It is in rectangular coordinate system. How we identify coordinate system? So the points are given in meters. So x, y, z. These three are in distance. So it is a Cartesian coordinate system. So we can write this r vector in Cartesian coordinate system. It is minus r minus 6 ax vector minus 7 ay vector plus 6 az vector. Then we find the modulus of r vector is 11. We know that the value of q1, q2 is given and epsilon naught is 8.84 into 10 power minus 12. We substitute all the values here. So after finding a distance vector from this, we can write the unit vector. You know what is a unit vector? Unit vector is a vector has a magnitude of unity and also indicates the direction of a vector under the consideration of the coordinate system. So unit vector is equal to vector divided by the modulus of the vector, that is magnitude of the vector. We know the distance vector, it is minus 6 ax vector minus 7 ay vector plus 6 az vector. It is divided by the magnitude of the vector 11. After calculating these values with the help of the calculator, finally you find F2 vector is minus 0.0133 AX vector minus 0.0155 AY vector plus 0.0133 AZ vector newtons. So in this way we calculate the force in vector form. We are calculating force acting on charge Q2 due to the charge Q1. This is one example. This is the third example. I consider a point charge Q1 is equal to 300 microcoulomb is located at 1, -1, -3 meter and experiences a force F is equal to 8 AX vector minus 8 AY vector plus 4 AZ vector newtons due to a point charge at 3, -3, -2 meters. Find the other charge Q2. So in this problem, force is given in vector form. Force is given, Q1 is given. Our job is we have to find what is Q2. We know the Coulomb's law. F vector is equal to Q1, Q2 by 4 pi epsilon naught r square a r vector. Okay, first we draw the diagram from the statement of the problem. Q1, Q2. The position of Q1 is 1, -1, -3. And the Q2 is 3, -3, -2. These are given in a Cartesian coordinate system. So Q1 is equal to 300 microcoulomb at the location 1, -1, -3 and Q2 at the location 3, -3, -2. We find the distance vector between the two charges and this is the distance vector minus 2 AX vector plus 2 AY vector minus AZ vector. Modulus of R vector is 3. From this we can easily write the unit vector along the direction of the R vector. Vector is r vector divided by the magnitude of the vector is modulus of r vector. It is minus 2 ax vector plus 2 ay vector minus az vector divided by 3. F vector is according to Coulomb's law, it is q1 q2 by 4 by epsilon naught r square ar vector. We substitute what is q1 q2 and r square ar vector and using the calculator you simplify that. In the left hand side we write the expression for the force vector which is given in the problem 8 ax vector minus 8 ay vector plus 4 ez vector is equal to minus 99,863.8 q2 by 4 into 8 ax minus 8 ay plus 4 az vector. We simplify this expression. Finally, we will get q2 is equal to minus 40 microcoulomb. So, in this video, we have seen three different types of problems. In the first example, just we calculate the gravitational force and the electric force. We conclude that electric force is much greater than the gravitational force. In the second example, from the second example, we know that how to calculate the force the given specification. In the third example, we found unknown charge for the given force. From the given force and one charge is known, from that we calculate the another charge Q2. I hope you could understand how to solve the problems based on Coulomb's law. Thank you.